often there is the need to see whether two objects are the same, and the object class provides two methods, equals and hash code, that determine equality. Sometimes there is a need to see whether two variables have a reference to the same object, and this is what exactly what happens when an object variable is passed as a parameter to a method, because the parameter will have the same reference to the object, to an object. It's the same reference as the object variable. This also happens when an object variable is assigned to another variable. To check that these variables have the same reference, the equals equals operator should be used, and this is called reference equality. But this doesn't account at all about the content of the objects, of the object, and the state, the internal state of the object. To see whether two objects are the same internally, so to test content equality, the equals method can be used, but it has to be overridden. Because in the default implementation in the object class, the test is just a reference equality. That's because there are no fields in the object class. So there is nothing to compare, nothing to compare with, because there are no fields. So overriding this method in the particular class of the object that has to be tested, the procedure that should be done is to check each field, the set of fields in the two objects, and to check that they are the same. So in the student class, it will appear in the following way. And there is the parameter, the first test that should be done is reference equality for the case in which the object has been passed a reference to itself to compare against. So in this case, the equality should be true. And this is an efficiency improvement. Then there is the issue that the parameter that is passed is of a class object, so there is no guarantee that the types that will be compared against will be the types of the objects will be the same. So a test needs to be done for this. And if the two types are not the same, it doesn't make sense to check if they are equal because they will not have the same fields. So this test will make this case return false. So, to do that, how it should be done. I don't know. Okay, I'll try anyways. Ah, yeah, instance of. Okay. Oh no, wait. This instance of OBJ. No, if OBJ is not the instance of this. Just like this. Or I don't remember exactly the syntax. So then now we're sure we have a student object of type student, object of type student. So now we can get the details of this object. So we perform a cast and assign this cast to a new variable of type student. And then we use the fact that private elements can be directly accessed by the instances of an object, and this is essential in this situation because not necessarily there will be accessor methods for each field. Now instead of using a reference equality, content equality will be used for testing the name and ID here. Will be like this again. Name however, this last statement can be made shorter, can be reduced to just id.equals.test.id, because whenever we know that a field is unique for has a unique value for every object, then even if two student objects have just different id distance, they are already they are different objects, and when the two IDs are equal, then everything else is equal, because the ID field uniquely identifies an object. It will be like this. Now, also, when the equals method is overridden, the hash code method should be also overridden. The hash code method, in its default implementation, returns an integer value that is computed from the object and the content of the object, and it is used. It is used especially for data structures like hash map and hash set to make efficient to make effectively work the lookup and the placement. Yes, the placement. So the hash code method is used by these collections to make efficient placement and lookup of objects into these collections. The hash code has a very important link with the equals method, which is that whenever two objects are the same when the equals method is invoked, also the hash code should be the same. This integer value that is returned by hash code. This is defined in the API of hash code in the JavaCast library as a contract or stipulation, and there are techniques to compute the hash code. The one that will be used is one from Joshua Bloch's book Efficient Java, which computes this integer value using the fields. So in this case, I could do something like this. So a random value is computation is done so that the order of adding the fields of computing the fields to make the hash code matters. So change the values. So there is credits, which is an integer. Or let's start with name ID, which is strings. So name dot hash code. And credits is an int, so it will be like this. By the way, hash codes do not necessarily have to be different when two objects are different. Okay, let me check in the book if it's in that way, because I have some doubt. Yeah, it's okay. Oh, of course. I'm already adding the result. So like this, and this should be initialized. Okay, this part seems wrong. Okay. Okay, it's used like this. This is as of the class student. And here I can give a more meaningful name, author. And I can return immediately the result of this. Now, what is the problem? It should be possible with blue type things. I did it equals 14.id. This is strange. Yes, it says that ID has private access. Person. Okay, so person. Yes, because it is not a field of student, it's a field of person. So maybe now, because there is this inheritance, it cannot work this way, because student doesn't have this field. It inherits it. So it's author dot super dot id. Then it should work. Now there is a problem with inheritance, but anyways. I don't know how to solve this. I think that's this the person, but then it's of different type. And instead cannot access. I don't know.